The Bible says, this is Cornelius speaking to Peter. Now, we are all present before God to hear all things commanded you by God. This is Cornelius. Here, Peter comes into the home of Cornelius, and Cornelius said, we are all present before God to hear all things commanded you by God. I believe, even in this place today, you are all present to hear and receive. But mark my words here. When I was working on the message and meditating on it, the Lord impressed upon me very strongly that all does not mean just everyone. We are all present to hear and receive does not just mean everyone present in the house. But the Lord impressed upon me very strongly that you all, even in this place, means you all, spirit, soul, and body. You all in this place, you are present to receive if you are present, spirit, soul, and body. What does it mean? Physically, body-wise, you all who I can see are present. But I'm not very sure. I don't know how many are present in the soul. It is possible you can be in a meeting like this one and your body is here, but your mind is outside. Some of you maybe now are driving to Independence. Some of you maybe are driving to Winthrop or some other places. Some of you right now maybe are in the kitchen. You are sorting out spices in your kitchen. So you are here body-wise, but your soul, your mind, your thinking is not here. So you are not present and you may miss what is meant for you. Then some of you could be here, body-wise, could be here, your mind is here, but your spirit, you are not born again, you are not in Christ, so you are not in the Lord, you are not present before God, you are elsewhere, you belong to another camp. So what am I saying? You must be present, spirit, soul, and body. What does it mean? If you are not born again, you must give your life to Jesus Christ, so that spirit-wise, you may be here. If you have backslidden and I share the word of God, you must just meditate on rededicating yourself to the Lordship of Jesus Christ so that as you hear the word, you all, the whole totality of you, spirit, soul, and body, is present to receive also together. That is very, very important. So in the name of Jesus, I draw your attention, spirit, soul, and body, to be present. You know what? Sometimes some people can be in a service, and you may see them as if they are writing notes. Maybe they are drawing cartoons. If you check their notes, you find there's a kangaroo there or a koala, and you are surprised. Oh, I thought they were taking notes. No, they were just present physically, but in the mind, they were in Australia drawing koalas and kangaroos. We move on. So we must be present. Be present to hear and to receive. Today, when you hear, not only with your ears, with your mind and your spirit, you will receive in the name of Jesus. The blessings are the Lord's doing, but the Lord blesses us through his servants. Very important here. The blessings are the Lord's doing, but the Lord blesses us through his servants. What do I mean? The Bible in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 20 says, have faith in God, believe in God that you may be established, but also believe in his prophets that you may prosper. It is not good enough to just believe in a God of miracles without believing and having confidence in the vessel that he may have chosen to bless you through in that hour and that moment. So many people have faith in God, but they don't have faith in the servant that is ministered to them in the moment. What am I saying? Look at it this way. Cornelius told Peter in Acts 10:33, now we are all present before God. Cornelius was not seeing God physically. He was seeing Peter, but he said, we are all present before God to hear all things commanded you by God. It simply means Cornelius and household had faith in God. They also had faith in Peter as a servant of God, so they were present to receive. They had faith in God, faith in the servant of God. No matter how anointed I may be, or how wonderful the message I may have, if you only have faith in God, but you have no faith in me, I can't deliver to you what is coming from God through me. You can only get what is coming from God through me if you have faith in God and also have faith in me. Believe in God, have faith in God that you may be established. Have faith in his prophets that you may prosper. Thank you. Also together. That is why if you go to a place or you sit in a church or you watch a program on television, And the minister who is speaking, you don't have faith in them, they can't bless you. But other people can be blessed by those people. And that's why sometimes there are people that you love so much to hear when they minister, and every time they minister, they bless you. It's because you have faith in God and have faith in them. Also together. Now, for you to reap the maximum benefits of our meeting today, you must have faith in God, also have faith in me as God's servant. By honoring Peter, Cornelius and household positioned themselves to receive from God. When you honor God, when you have faith in God and his servants, you become like a vacuum cleaner. You know, a vacuum cleaner draws dirty from the carpet. But here, we're talking about you positioning yourself as a vacuum cleaner to draw dirty, but to draw the anointing. So when I speak here, you must have faith. This brother, this pastor, this man is not from here. He has come from afar. I'm sure there must be something that he has carried for me to cross the ocean to come this far. On my part, I have that faith. On my part, I know I am loaded, but I do not know about your part. Look at it this way. Romans chapter 1, verse 11. The Apostle Paul says, writing to the Romans, I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift, that you may be established. I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift, that you may be established. Then in verse 12 of Romans chapter 1, he says, but I would like you to encourage me with mutual faith. In other words, I long to bless you. You must also long to be blessed. If the minister is the only one that longs to bless, but the recipients are unwilling, nothing will be transferred, nothing will flow. There must be mutual faith. I long to bless, you must long to receive. When that takes place, then the blessings flow. When you go to a ministry or a meeting, a church or whatever program, when you are a minister and you have people before you who long, who have faith to receive and you want to give, when you meet, then the transfer takes place. When you meet people, you may look at them and see them. You may know that by God's grace, you have what they need. But if they are not longing or willing to receive, nothing can go to them. And that's where the scripture now comes. Though the language is very hard, but I just want you to see the picture here. Jesus Christ says, do not throw your pearls before swines, because they will just trample upon them. Sometimes, how many times have we done that? You think you have something very precious. You may even go to some of your relatives who are not saved, and you tell them, you know what? Be born again, you know? You need Jesus. And they say, what rubbish. What you are giving them is pearls, but they are not ready to receive them, so they trample on it. And that's why sometimes Jesus will pass through some places. He's looking for those who have faith to receive. When he meets them, they receive. With the other fellows, he just goes through. Also together. So when you have some precious stuff, but people don't need it, nothing will flow. If you give it, they just trample upon it. That which is heavenly is precious. So today, I want you to position yourself as a vacuum cleaner, to believe and trust God that God is faithful, that he must have brought me here for a purpose. There are so many places I could have gone to by God's grace and willingness. But why has he made it possible for me to come over here? It simply means there is someone here in the house, maybe all of us, who may have been positioned by God to receive what is being spoken. Remember what I said. I said this message is a prophetic message for the now. I'm standing here like a delivery boy. So there are people here in this place who have been praying, who have been sowing. So this word has to come to say, now is the moment for you to receive your answers. I will sit together. So we move on. The Holy Ghost fell on all them that heard the word, because Peter was anointed to minister. In Acts chapter 10, verse 38, the Bible says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Jesus was able to do what he did because he had the anointing upon him to do what he did. Peter was able to minister the way we have heard the report because God's hand was upon him. Remember, the Bible in Acts chapter 10, verse 20, the Bible says, the Spirit told Peter, go to the household of Cornelius, doubting nothing. And in verse 29, he says, so I came without objection. So the Lord also told me, go to the States, go wherever I open a door for you. So I have come doubting nothing. I have come without objection. And I have said this before, I believe even last year, there is no place on this planet where God has taken me to share the word by his doing. There is no place where I have not found someone positioned by God to be blessed accordingly. What may vary is the numbers. Sometimes it may be everyone, but there's always one person. Because that's a covenant agreement with me, that when you send me to places, your word must not return void. So sometimes the word can be resisted, but God makes sure, for his word to be really established, he makes sure at least one person will be spoken or touched to accordingly. I don't know who that person is in this place, but I know you are here. Even when I speak, you know. The things of God are very simple. The things of God are of the Spirit. If I speak by the Spirit of God, by the Spirit of God with you, he also bears witness that this is yours, this is yours, this is my message. There are some of you, even before you saw me, or maybe you saw me last year, even when you heard about the meeting, you got excited in your spirit. You got excited in your heart. It is not just a superficial excitement. It was the doing of the Holy Spirit. Because the Spirit who causes you to be excited is the same Holy Spirit who tells me what message to speak. So it is him that orchestrates all the arrangement. Just like he spoke to Cornelius, he also speaks to Peter, and the two meet. So he prepares you, he also prepares me. Then when we meet, we just undertake the transfer of the blessings. Are we still together? What am I saying? As I've come here today, in my spirit, I fully know very well, fully persuaded and convinced that I have some blessings. I have some answer to your needs. I have some blessings on me, put upon me by God, with your name on it. So even as I minister here, you are several there, you are so many of you. But on me, by his grace, for this particular mission, there are some gifts, there are some blessings upon me, with your name on it. But you, by your faith, by positioning yourself right, you turn yourself into a vacuum cleaner to draw from what I'm carrying that which is yours. So you draw it by faith, because without faith you can't please God. So I have some blessings that were intended or meant for the people who would be gathered in this fellowship today. Don't allow me to go back to Zambia with excess baggage. In any case, now they don't want too much luggage on the planes. I have come. Let my bag be opened. Zip opened totally, turn the bag upside down, dust everything that was meant for this place. Don't allow me to go with what was intended for you. So I have a blessing with your name on it. But to draw it, you must have faith in God. You must have faith in God that God loves you so much that he can speak to someone in Zambia, prepare them to speak this message which you need in this hour and this day. That is the way we receive from the Lord. Are we still together? A man can receive nothing except it be given him from heaven. That's what John 3:27 says. A man can receive nothing except it be given him from heaven. So you are here to receive because you have been given by heaven. I know when we are gathered in this place that we have so many needs. But I also know very well that I don't have all the answers to your needs. I only have a measure of your answers. There are some that God has prepared for you today to deliver through me. If I had all the answers for you, then today would be your last service on the earth, because I'll give you all the answers and we go home. No, we have part of the answer. So today I stand here to bless you. What again remains? Other ministers, other servants of God will come again to bless you. So we keep imparting, we keep giving. With God, all things are possible, but with man, some things are impossible. With God, all things are possible, but with me as a minister, only those things which by his grace he has decided for me to deliver in this day and this hour will be possible. And I'm saying unto you, there is stuff with your name on it. You must receive what is meant for you. That's why this meeting has been organized by God. Of course, he uses people. He may use the Ritz, he may use Marlene, but God uses people. But he had you in mind to be blessed accordingly.